first come in here, there was a time when you retained a vestige of old world courtesy, namely, respect for your elders and betters.
When I first come in here, you taught me the value of peace and quiet. I'm in accordance with that thought now.
Meaning,
do not disturb.
All right, suit yourself, not another word. Not another word, you'll pass my lips. My lips are sealed for. Forthwith, my lips are sealed. My lips are sealed with four. Yeah?
You weren't gonna say nothing.
Oh, sorry now, sorry. Show me the couch, sir, all right? Honey?
Nothing, eh?
No, no, I just want to take a minute.
What?
What have I got in my hand?
Look, I don't care, Fletch. Go away.
No, come on, it's a good one. It's a good one. It's come on, I'll take a minute. What have I got in my hand?
A cockroach?
No.
I'll give up.
I've got two more guesses, haven't you?
All right, a walnut.
A walnut? It's not Christmas. Where'd I get a bloody walnut from?
All right, it's a giraffe with a hair lip wearing purple wire fronts.
You've been peeping, haven't you? Come on, did you like that? That's what I was good at. Right, I'll do it again. Plus, I've got
it wrong. Look, Major, now for. I've asked you nicely. I've got an exam to pass and I've got to study.
Well, study, study. Just study somewhere else, that's all.
Where, for instance?
Well, the education room, for instance. That's a good for instance.
Look, there's a lecture in there tonight. The accident prevention officer is speaking on industrial safety.
That's been cancelled, eh?
Was it?
Yeah. On his way here, the accident prevention officer fell off his bike. Is it Carlisle General now?
I wish you were.
Listen, God, but there's two men you're selling here, you know. Two men to a cell. It's very unsettling for a social misfit like myself to have a bloke sat there trying to better himself all the time.
Look, when I get out of here, I'll probably have another O-level. What will you have to show for it, eh? Another stretch done.
Oh, yes, oh, yes.
Well, the town cries, you know.
What's going on here? Heated argument, is it? Raised voices?
Blame your mother, superior.
You watch your lips, Fletcher.
My lips are sealed, sir. Forthwith, my lips are sealed.
If only that were true.
What is the problem? Goodbye.
Look, I'm trying to study, Mr. Mackay. You're always encouraging it, aren't you? Rehabilitation, education. Only there's nowhere in his nothing that conducive to it.
Yes. Well, you wouldn't expect that to cut much ice with an aging recidivist like Fletcher.
Aging what?
Recidivist. A person who pays his penance for performing a crime goes out and straight off performs another one.
Oh, you mean a professional?
No, I mean an habitual criminal. Something you may not have been if you'd stuck into your education like the lad over here.
Well, I never finished my school, you see. I never really got as far as exams. What was it, school certificate in my day?
Yes, I can imagine.
But I was always playing truant, you know.
Oh, yes.
It was the war. The war. Always out on the bomb sites looking for shrapnel and that. Learned about sex and the air raid shelters. So, basically, of course, I finished up at a special school for other blokes who was always playing truant, you know, but we never learned nothing.
And why not?
No one ever turned up at school.
See me? See me?
Yeah, I do.
I had to leave school at 14. Helped bring a living wage into the house. Hard times as well in the Lancashire coalfields. My father was an unemployed miner, but there were still eight children to provide for.
Oh, eight kids, eh? He wasn't unemployed a whole time,
eh? I hear you correctly, Fletcher.
No, you did not, sir.
Now, let me tell you this. Not one of our family neglected education. Not one of them, even under the most difficult circumstances, like young God by you. I've had to pass exams, you know. Aspects of the Reformation. What's the subject you're studying, God?
History, a level. I already got one A-level before I come in here.
That's the spirit, lad, you see again. And I'm telling you, Fletcher, no, I'm ordering you. You do nothing to end up this lad's concentration. Otherwise, get out.
No, I just come in from work, I'm entitled.
You are entitled to nothing in here except to obey the sound of my voice. When's the exam, sir?
2 days. Time.
Right, so you make yourself scarce, Fletcher. Now, is that clear?
I'll go out for the evening, if you like. Leave the keys, I'll let myself in. So I can't sit my own flowery down now in case I disturb his nip's concentration here.
Look, you can't get quiet, Fletcher. It's not much to ask. Means a lot to me, this exam does.
History.
Yeah?
History and geography.
What do you mean?
Well, it don't mean anything, does it, in real life, does it?
Look, the point is not what exam I get. The point is whether I get an exam at all. That's what's going to impress any future employer. That I have enough intelligence and diligence to pass an exam even under the most adverse circumstances imaginable.
Not easy studying the nick, no?
Well, all I've said is worth a try, and I'm trying.
Oh, well, I'll be it from here, etc. Quiet enough for you?
Thank you.
You will not know I'm here.
Evening, lads.
Shh. What's up?
Nothing, heck.
I didn't ask him round, did
it's
I?
It's impossible.
What's up? It's a seat of learning in here, a seat of learning. Professor Godbert is studying for his MBG.
He's always at that larky's length.
Oh, I'll to it. I give up.
A bit of orange.
I know knowledge. What are we talking about? You know knowledge. You can't even read it quick.
Maybe not, but I get it all from the telly. From University Challenge. Sale of the century. I learn things that are digested with my memory. Shall I give you an example?
No. Nope.
Well, apparently, are you listening? Glenn?
Yeah.
Apparently, if every Chinaman in China jumped up and down at the same moment, like, it would cause a tidal wave which would engulf America.
Really?
Straight up. Or is it Australia? You know, that could be a secret weapon, couldn't it, eh? I mean, the Chinese could hold that over President Carter's head, couldn't they? I mean, one jump up and down, yeah. Whoosh, world domination, you know.
Yeah, yeah. They wouldn't though, would they?
Well, they might, you know, knowing the Chinese. Yes. If anyone could pull it off, they could, because, well, I mean, they're very, very regimented, aren't they? They do everything by numbers, don't they? I mean, look at the menu in a Chinese restaurant. Of course, it could never happen in Britain, you know.
Well, it could, you know, if we put our minds to it.
No, no, the British working man wouldn't demean himself by jumping up and down. Might spill his tea, wouldn't
he? Still, that is knowledge, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, that's knowledge, all right, yeah.
When did you acquire this fascinating bit of information about it? Oh, somebody read it to me out of a magazine in this Chiropodist waiting room.
Oh, dear. What's the matter with you? Toothache?
No, no, I was there with my feet, you see.
Oh, naturally, yes.
Yeah. I've always had these feet. It's a very good Chiropodist, though. They're very quick.
Oh, aren't they? Don't worry, wait, do they?
Hey?
Well, I mean, do you have to leave them there? They said I'll be ready Thursday. You know, something near that.
Get off. You're pulling your leg flat.
I wouldn't dare. Your foot might come off, wouldn't it?
Hey, I've got some more knowledge, you know. It's even better. It's about planets.
Oh, dear. Even better about planets. Are you taking all this down in?
I took it down in.
Right, come on. Has anyone got a football?
No, we haven't got a football.
Oh, never mind. I can use someone else. Fletch, can I borrow one of your satsumas?
Not to use the football, you can't.
No. What's that doing? I don't need ping pong ball.
What is all this about, Arnold?
I'll show you.
I want that back. I'm bruised, right?
Yes. Now, we haven't got a football, have we? So I'll tell you what. I'll use this jerry to be the sun. Of course, it should be round like a football because the sun's round, you know.
No, it wouldn't be any good if it's round, would it?
Why not?
Well, you can sit on it, keep rolling off.
But let him get on with it.
Here, here. It's all in the sun tomorrow, that's what you're doing. Get on with it,
come on. So, right, pretend the jerry's a football, but it's really the sun.
I am,
right?
I am.
Now, this ping pong ball is supposed to be the planet Mercury.
Oh, I see.
Excuse me, Fletch, it goes in.
Oh, does it, yeah?
Because it's nearest the sun.
Oh, right. I'm going to sit over here in the shade.
Yeah. One, two, three, four. Excuse me, Fletch, you're sitting where the Earth goes.
Do you know? Is there anyone watching us?
No. Now, this Satsuma is supposed to be the planet Earth,
yeah?
And that goes here.
Oh, see? Yeah.
Right. Now,
you missed out Venus.
You what?
Venus comes between Mercury and the Earth.
Yeah, about you.
Oh, that's right, yeah. And Venus is smaller than the Earth, so we need something smaller than a Satsuma.
Your brain.
Fletch, have you got the prune?
No, Chris, I haven't got a prune. No, I did have some prunes, but they went all wrinkled, so I chucked them out. Why don't we skip Venus, eh?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So, Sun, Mercury, skip Venus, Earth. Now then, how far would the nearest star be on this scale from this cell where we are now? Lemme.
Is this one of these trick questions, Warren?
No, no, no.
Because if it is, I'll stuff you.
No, honestly, wait up.
Sun, Mercury, Earth.
Yeah.
On this scale.
On this scale.
Where would the nearest star be to where we are now?
Outside, yeah.
Well, I reckon it'd be Recreation Yard.
Wrong! Fletch.
Recreation Yard? It's not be wrong, is it? Eh? Recreation Yard.
It's a long way.
Well, in that case, I would say the American Quarter.
No, you're wrong and all.
Not by much, I bet.
Johannesburg.
Never in a thousand years, Johannesburg.
The truth is, the nearest star would be in Johannesburg. Or is it Australia?
I just can't believe it. You two will probably drive me around and twist you, will.
What's wrong? That's learning, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, what have I learned today, eh? Sun's a chamber pot, which is really a football. And given the unlikely probability that 600 million Chinese jump up and down in unison, America will drown.
What have I said?
You finished with the sun over here, have
you? It's the exam, is it?
Yeah,
strain, like?
Yeah. Well, I don't know doors in any case.
History.
History at this present point in time. Yes, he happens to be studying history, yeah. But you know him as well as I do. He's been through every napping course in his nick like a dose of salt here.
Yeah. He gets discouraged so easy. Look how quick he jacked in elementary Spanish.
Was elementary, you know, wasn't it, eh? After 4 weeks, he only knew the words for bread and donkey. That's not going to get you very far in Spain, is it, eh? Unless you want to live on donkey sandwiches.
Well, I think he gives up easy because you undermine his confidence.
Oh, it's my fault, is it?
Yes. It's hard enough to study in here, but you distract him.
Just hold your horses, Fanny, a minute. If he does pass this exam, it will be due in no small part to yours truly.
How?
How? He's learned a lot from me, yes. I've kept him up half the night, many's the time, lecturing him on World War II, as told by someone who lived through it, me.
Is that his subject in World War II?
Well, it's all the same, isn't it? War's a war, isn't it? It's all history, isn't it?
No, but... So what I mean is, Fletch, I think like this exam means a lot to young Lenny. To himself, like. And if he sets a lot of store by this exam and then fails, well, you know...
What, might turn him a bit sour, you mean?
Well, shatter his confidence, like. He'll just suck it and go back to thieving.
Well, then... You and I and the lads must unite in the rehabilitation of Lenny Copper.
If we can.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Before he sits for this exam, we've got to go all through the questions with him. Make sure he passes. So he can go out there into life with a feeling of honesty and integrity.
How can we go through the questions with him?
Well, there's only one way, isn't there? You and me have got to get down the education room and see your exam papers.
Smithin, this manuscript of yours.
Oh, you like it, do you? I always wanted to write. I always felt I had it in it, you know. Right, literary bent, like.
Yes, well, it's very interesting. It's brutal, but it's interesting.
Well, it could mean a lot to me if I became a writer. See, nobody in my family's ever been famous, except for my cousin Ernie.
Your cousin Ernie was a notorious tearaway.
Well, still famous though, wasn't he? He got into the top 10.
Yeah, top 10 most wanted men, yeah.
Aye, he made a name for himself, but he couldn't go into a post office man without seeing a photo of Warroni.
No, well, You see, Spaghan, I think that writing might be your escape, if you pardon the expression. So I'd be the last one to stand in your way, but I really do think you ought to start with some grammatical essentials, you see. Now, on page one, this first paragraph, you see, there's a K in knuckle-dust. As there is also in kneecaps. Kneecaps? Yes, well, the ones you smash with a cricket bat at the top of page two.
I know I haven't put much grammar in there, like, and I know my spelling leaves a lot to be desired, but, see, I didn't want to interrupt my flow of self-conscious, you know. See, I write with me gut.
Yes, I noticed that.
Wait a minute. What do you mean up there? Balls, Mr. McCoy. Why, the different sizes? That's life, sir. Get your hair cut. You too, Jones.
Oh, excuse us. Oh, hello, Sprex. Not disturbing, are we?
Oh, no, you're right.
Yeah, I hate to interrupt the literary flow, like, you know, because we're all very glad that you've laid down a sword and picked up a pen, you know, as indeed our many battered night watchmen on your way.
What is it, Fletcher? What do you mean, boss?
Well, we want to see the education officer, Mr. Bearcuff, you know, the one with the brains.
Yes, well, Mr. Kingsley's taken a class. I'm just lending a hand with one of his more brutal brains.
Can you settle an argument?
Yeah, an intellectual argument.
Yes, I mean, won't it wait? I'm dealing with Spaggan.
Oh, Spraggan can wait. He's been waiting 4 years for parole, ain't you?
Yes, well, all right, then. What is it?
Well, you see, we were all sitting in our cell, as one does, discussing the wonders of the universe, you know.
You know what?
Anyway, look, Warren here had this theory, you see, that McLaren and I were disputing, right?
Theory? What theory?
Well, let me show you. Now, get it right now. You see, there is a football, but that represents the sun, right?
Of course, it hasn't got handles like the Jerry, but at least it's round.
Don't confuse the man, don't confuse him. Now, you see, the sun, that goes just there, you see? Now, that represents the planet Mercury, see this ping-pong ball? And the ping-pong ball goes there. Now, we're going to skip Venus, because we haven't got prunes, you see, follow that. Now, tennis ball represents the Earth, but we're using that because it doesn't bruise like a satsuma, right? Now, and also, of course, you can't bounce a satsuma, can you? Grab it. Right, McLaren, would you now show Mr. Barraclough where this ball goes in relationship? Lovely sense of rhythm I've got these guys.
There's not enough room in here, Fletcher.
Maybe,
Oh, yeah, that's a good idea. Could we all step into the corridor, Mr. Barraclough, because you can't get the galaxy in the rooms.
You just simply adjust your proportions. You bring that ball nearer to this
one. No, it's got to be on the scale. Got to be on the scale.
Excuse me, Inspector, I've got a better view than you.
Oh, sorry, one.
Mr. Education Officer, keep the keys.
What keys?
The filing cabinet in there.
Hey. That's my tutor, old Kingsley and Barra. They might be screws, but they're okay. Before I met them, I didn't know an apostrophe from a semicolon man. When my book's published, I might dedicate it to old Barra, because he trusts me, and you're expecting me to be three laps trust, eh? My knock off.
Listen, tell us where the keys are. There's an ounce of snout in it for you.
They're in that drawer.
If a thing is worth doing at all, it's worth doing well. There's no point in spoiling the ship for a half of the tar, isn't it? Now, I've got the very things here. There we are now. Jupiter and Saturn. For Sanctora is the nearest star. See, I mean, it's funny, it's one of my hobbies, you know. But I don't think on that scale that it's as far away as Johannesburg, you see.
Oh, if you manage to work it out, Mr. Barraclough, you know where we are, don't you? Well, we're in most evenings, you know. Yes, Rex.
No, just a minute. Could I have my... Oh, well, never mind.
Thanks for your valuable time, Mr. Barraclough.
Yeah, much appreciated.
Very thank you. But, you know, I do believe they enacted that entire elaborate charade just to steal my apples.
Still out of here, are we?
Trying, yeah.
You know what I say, don't you? All work, no play makes Jack a dull beanstalk.
Do us a favour, Fletcher.
Already have done, son.
All right, look, you left yourself for half an hour, but did you have to come back so soon?
I thought you'd be worried, little flower, eh? I thought you'd miss me. I thought you'd worry if I didn't return from Granny's by nightfall.
Where you been?
Down the educational.
What for?
Oh, we thought we'd enroll in a course, didn't we, one?
Yes.
What? Trigonometry.
What's that?
I think it's too short playing, Jimmy.
Well, go on, tell him.
What
trigonometry is.
Well, if you don't know now...
It's about time someone told me, isn't it? Go on, tell him.
Don't adopt that sarky tongue with me, God.
Look, Fletcher, I will be the first person in this nick to admit that I owe you a lot, but one of the reasons I so desperately want to pass this exam is so I have a chance of not ending up like you.
Just a minute, I'll have to think about that. That's an insult, isn't it?
Ungrateful, that's what. If he only knew.
Knew what?
Knew how much Fletch cares.
Now, let him alone. Leave him be.
Cares about what?
Cares about you, that's what.
One day he might. No, you tell him, Fletch. You tell him what you've done for the benefit of his nibs here, a great personal risk to yourself.
You played your small part, Warren, as indeed did McLaren. Now I'm beginning to wonder why we took such terrible risks.
What terrible risks? On my behalf? Look, the only thing I ask you to do on my behalf is to give me half a fighting chance of passing this exam.
Which is precisely what we have done, Gobba.
We're only going to make sure you pass it, aren't we?
How? By going through the questions with you so you can select the appropriate answers.
Well, in that case, it would be useful to have the appropriate questions.
You've got them.
What's this?
Tomorrow's exam paper. Now hurry up and have a look at it. We've got to put it back where it comes from.
the exam paper.
Yeah?
Well, you did it, didn't we?
No.
What do you mean, no?
I mean, no. I don't want to cheat. I want to pass this exam honestly.
Oh, yes, that would be very nice, wouldn't it? Listen, you can only afford honesty once you made it, mate. Passing this exam might help you make it.
Look, you don't understand. I've cheated all my life. That's why I'm where I am now. For one part of my life, I'd like to do something straight.
But when you've passed the exam, no one's going to know how you passed it.
I will. If I fail, I fail. But I ain't going to pass through cheating.
Now, listen, then. Listen. Now, look. I mean, cheating's not a crime. No, it's not. It isn't. It's just getting away with it. I mean, it's a world of difference. I mean, everybody cheats, don't they?
No, listen, Len, listen. You know when you play draughts with Fletch and he says he thinks one fell on the floor and could you pick it up? So you bend down and when you straighten up, you find the board's rearranged.
Yeah.
Well, that's all cheating.
That's right.
Oh, so you admit it.
Look, name of the game is getting away with it, right? It's not what you do, it's what you get caught doing.
And if you don't get caught?
Then you're away, ain't you? Home and dry.
No.
Now, listen, copper. You know when you watch your favourite television programme, Kojak, tell us about us, right? You think he's a great actor. You think he's a great actor. Do you know why he's always opening his filing cabinets, always looking at his cuffs all the time? Because he's got his lines written all over the place.
And that's cheating,
yeah. But who gives a monkeys? Nobody. Cheating's just another word for conning. Put your one over on people, that's all. Get your own way. I mean, if that was a crime, the whole bleeding country would be doing porridge, wouldn't it?
I'll tell you what would be a crime. You turning down this golden opportunity that we're handing you.
Yeah, we took a big risk to get it for you, lad.
I appreciate what you've done. And if you want me, thanks. Thanks. But I'll do it my way.
Well, if you do it your way, you're not honest, you're dumb. Because if you do it your way, you're gonna fight!
Look, there comes a point in everybody's life when the only person you're cheating is yourself. It's like cheating at patience.
Fletcher does that and all. Come on, Warren, come on. Yeah. Let's leave him to it, leave him to it. You're at the crossroads of your life, Bubba. You better start making yourself a few breaks, mate, because when you get out there, there'll be precious people for you. Listen, you could go for a job one morning with all the qualifications in the world and be picked at the post by some nerd who's never passed an exam in his life. But he speaks with a right accent. He plays for a cricket club. He ain't never been no nick.
Then he should be out of his exam soon, eh?
Yeah. Wonder how he got on. Here, we must never let him know we know, though.
Oh, no.